guys, John Caparetta, Green Suit Hero Guy here to say that we're gonna work out today. Gyms are finally open, Corona's still raging, but guess what? We're allowed to actually work out. First off, as every gym needs, you need to get your mask. Make sure you put that on properly and don't be an idiot. Follow the rules. And of course, right before you go in, you gotta make sure you lather yourself up with chalk. If we're gonna work out, we're gonna do this just right. Remember, be 100% liberal with this. Don't even matter, just put this shit on. Just do it!
Don't be a goddamn pansy.
Ah! Until it gets in your eyes. Oh god. Oh god. Oh my god. Who's ready to do some eye-ups? Now many people will tell you that you're supposed to do deadlifts, bench, and maybe even squat. But nah. That's not what we do. The non-copyrighted Green Suit Hero Guy is gonna teach you how to really work out just like a superhero. A lot of people think you gotta drink your protein after your workout. We are 100% wrong. You gotta get your protein in no matter what workout you're doing. It doesn't matter if you're planking. You just lift this down, look down, and just deep throat that.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Just like that. People think you need to do bench, just strictly bench, in order to get that superhero body. Well, guess what? They're 100% wrong. You gotta work on nothing but ass. We're gonna do the superhero ass. This is what you do. You get a band, you put it on your legs, and then you get a goddamn sledgehammer. Now you're worried, warning. What the hell are we gonna do with the sledgehammer? Easy. Follow the simple instruction. Legs up, out. Yeah. And you gotta make sure to put those sexual noises in, because that's how you get the testosterone flowing into your muscles. So one of the biggest things a superhero needs to do is be able to build a big, strong back and do cardio. One of the biggest cardios is running, and also one of the biggest back strengtheners is rowing. So what do we do both to cut out the time? We simply do both. So one of the things to being a phenomenal superhero is being able to move heavy as shit because you got strong as legs. Now you see that keg right there?
Yes.
If you can't move that keg, you ain't gonna be a superhero. Just like your non-copyrighted Green Suit Hero Guy right here. Let's do it.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
So one of the biggest things you gotta know about being a hero is that you gotta know how to fight. So I'm gonna teach you how to fight just like a super bro hero. You ready? Now pay close attention. My technique is 100% certified to let you win nearly any fight.
Come on, bro.
All right, people, so the very last thing, what we gotta do right here is very, very simple. We gotta take our pre-workout. No, we just don't ingest it. We just don't put it up the butt. We do it like real superheroes. So once you open your container, you just boom, right here. You see this? See this scoop? You just do a little bit. And then you put it right here. You do it right here. See that? You know what that looks like? That's delicious white powder that is technically an illegal drug. I'm not gonna say it because I don't want to get demonetized. So once you get your line perfectly ready, you just let me know there. And then you just get ready. You just get ready for your pre-workout.
Five things that changed in the gym after quarantine. Go!
Come on, you're gonna get me a little help here.
Come on, man, you got this. Come on, you can do this. Come on.
Get over here and help me.
Pick it up. You got this. Come on. Get up.
Stop trying to use the force and help me.
Be careful of the Rona. Oh no. Tomorrow.
Yeah, you know, I was just working out at home, you know, just doing my own thing because I have a home gym and everything. Well, a bunch of you pansies didn't even do anything during this whole quarantine.
Dude, why do you even come to the gym if you got one at your house? What's the whole point of that if you have a home gym?
Well, you know, I just wanted to come here and enjoy the whole gym idea. You know, I just got so goddamn lonely during this quarantine. I just want some human interaction.
Hey, man, I haven't seen you like in 3 months. What have you been doing this whole time?
Oh, you know, just doing some body weight workouts. Hey, you want to see something? Check it out. Yeah, impressive, huh? No, I'm good. It smells like feet in here. I'm not coming back. Nope.
Hello, God here.
Well, sir, the reason why I'm calling you is that if you look down below, you will see the world is on fire.
Huh?
Is me and Gabriel decided to mess with your code.
Why the hell would you do that? It was perfect, because it was made from me.
Yes, I know. You make everything absolute perfect, but we just thought we could add a little something different. But we don't know what else to do right now, sir.
I swear to myself, Abraham, if you don't get this done right now, I will start smiting you. These programs were set for 6 years, Abraham, not 6 months!
Yes, sir. We can definitely do that. We'll go back to the original code and try to, I don't know, maybe do some fear-mongering somewhere else, sir. I do have one question, sir.
What is it, Abraham?
If you're all-knowing and powerful and, you know, I'm not doubting everything, but why do you need assistance to run anything?
Do not ask the Almighty God why he needs assistance. Now, get back!
Yes, sir. Okay, don't worry. We got this. Okay, bye. Love you. Bye.
Now I can work on more important things. God damn it! What?
You rang?
Me?
What am I doing here again? Time to go to work. Better put on my support real quick.
Hurt so bad. Everybody, look in the sky.
It's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's. Oh, that's just rude.
Oh God, he's got a knife. Put the supplements in the gym bag, and Noah's decaps will be coming home tonight with me. So much better. And then, dude, I just caught that play. Boom! Touchdown. And that is how I won our independent league frothing game. Yeah. Hey, where are you going? Honey, why is there a camera here? Are we really doing this?
we starting the porno? Is that what we're doing? I don't remember talking about this. Honey, I don't like this. I don't like this. But wait a second. I'm not even married.
Hey guys, Just Call Me Dutch here, or your favorite non-copyrighted suit hero guy here to say, we're gonna find out how to get your protein in many different ways. First off, you gotta understand, yes, you can just ingest it, you can drink it, or you can stuff it right up your butt. But guess what? I found out many different ways you can get it. And we're gonna go off with one of my first one right now.
So some of you knobheads have to understand that here's the thing. You gotta soak with the protein.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
You have to understand what it feels like to be protein. So you have to take a bath with your protein. Feel like you're a protein shake. Understand it. Be psychological. And know the meaning is to ingest your favorite types of protein on a daily event.
This needs to stop now. This is cancer.
When you need your protein shake at 6:30,
yeet.
But you got a party at 7 p.m.
yeet.
And you want to drink it like a man, what do you do? You pour them together.
Oh, yeah.
We're about to have some fun. Cheers! Power!
What? I couldn't hear that.
Power!
What?
Bastard! When you're fighting someone that's superior in you in every single physical possible way, you're gonna need an extra boost in life. Power!
So, you looking for a good time?
What you got?
Let me read that sign there. I got something better. I got creatine.
I could work with that.
Professional will tell you protein needs to be properly absorbed into the actual digestive system. But I'm going to tell you you're 100% wrong. You need to absorb the protein anywhere possible. And you know how we're going to do that? We're gonna take a shower with actual protein.
What the hell did you just say?
Do you understand what I'm saying? You gotta wet your hair, make sure all your hair follicles get nice and wet, because you wanna absorb it from the hair all the way down to the whole gonadotype. From all the way from the hair to your skin and slowly down to your feet, because then it'll allow you to properly absorb this 100% protein right here. So we're just gonna put it on top and lather it in our hair. Absorb every little possible fiber that we fucking can. Just don't get in your eyes. That's when it stings, but you still need that protein. So keep the eyes open, okay? Just keep your eyes open during this whole process. Trust me, I'm 100% credible.
At the end of the day, when all else fails, all you have to do is go to your local nutrition store and get your favorite flavor of protein.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh, come on, man.
You maniacs. You closed it on my day off.
What's closed?
GNC, look.
It's open.
Shut up, it's for the video. Stop.
Cannot wait to go play with my friends.
Slow down there, partner. You didn't pay for today's new game. What new game? I already purchased the game yesterday. I understand that, but today's new game is better quality, better graphics, updated monetization, and trust me, only minor transactions. Okay, I understand. You're a little bit skeptical. I understand that, but, check it out.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm not
paying for that. See, this is why no one likes EA anymore. You're constantly putting out bullcrap video games with updated modifications, better graphics, and you're constantly destroying fan franchises like Lucas.
How's this? I throw in the Tom Brady cutout for the season, but only an extra $2.
What the hell?
Where'd he go?
Pay for the next season of Tom Brady cutout in order to continue playing with him.
Oh, you son of a bitch!
Hey, man. We need to go to the store right now. They gave me some medicine from the situation last night.
It is useless to meet revenge with revenge. It will heal nothing.
Dude, you have no idea what I'm feeling right now. I can't wait overnight for this. So please, let's get up before traffic gets any worse.
Then we must take the high road. A road unforeseen. There lies our hope. If hope it be. To walk into barrel. To Mordor. We must send the ring to the fire.
Dude, I don't want to think about my lower proximities like that. So get your butt up. Let's get moving so I can get this magic wizard cream so I can get this shit fixed before it's too late.
A wizard is never late, young man, nor is it early. He arrives precisely when he needs to be. For the love of Christ, if you do not get a move on, I'm going to beat the ever-living snot at you. Now this problem is turning my insides inside out. Okay, so if you please get a move on, I would like to keep a couple inches of my health on me right now, okay?
Even the smallest person can change the course of the future.
My future is about to come to an end if you don't move your ass right now.
The board is set, the pieces are moving. We come to it at last, the great battle of our time.
Just get in the car, man.
I will take the ring. Though I do not know the way! Use GPS and drive!
Just another day at the gym. Finally, enjoying myself like I used to do. Oh man, I'm gonna do some legs, maybe some bench, and maybe...
What? What the hell? This place is closed!
Oh yeah, lockdown again. Where the hell am I supposed to get my workout going now?
Fuck it.
Where's he next?
That way.
Let's go. Thank you. You all have a good day. Thank you.
This is Just Call Me Dutch.
And today, we got a little something special for you.
As you already know, San Diego, California is dealing with a second lockdown. Isn't that great? So again, I can't even go outside without shit already happening.
So what exactly are we gonna do this time during this lockdown?
Cry that the gyms are closed?
We're not gonna do that. Again.
We're literally going to do ghetto lifting workout.
As you actually see here in the bags, I literally filled these bags with nothing but actual sand I bought at Home Depot.
But why?
So let's do some sample workouts.
Curls for the girls, shrugs for some hugs,
front raises for their cock raises.
Move to the next scene.
Farmer carries for the longer carries.
Why do these workouts feel oddly familiar?
You've been doing this kind of stuff since you were a kid. You take groceries from your car on the first try because you ain't no goddamn bitch.
Oh my God, I've been training this moment my whole life.
What, lockdown time?
No, you buffoon. Ghetto lifting workouts. Thank you. Thank you, grocery gods.
You are welcome, my fat ass son.
But now, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna have some real fun.
Yeah!
There we go. You see this thing? This is a keg. Now, I understand some of you might have probably bought one during this lockdown, but now we filled it with sand.
Why would you do that? Why would you do any of that?
We are now going to not only drink the calories from this keg, but we're also now going to burn the calories with this keg. I know, it's extremely difficult, and our lives have vastly changed because of the lockdown. This tin can is not going to control your life. You listen to me, little shit? You're not going to control my life. I'm going to lift you around. Ow. Ow. Anyways, we are going to lift this keg. As you can see, this thing weighs roughly about 170 pounds filled with sand. Now, this not only works out your grip strength, your back strength, and, of course, your core strength and your legs. But who really does legs nowadays? Be careful when you actually do this lift because it can get extremely complicated because if you make a mistake, you're going to have a bad day. So make sure it's right under you. You lift this bad boy up just like that. And remember, have complete control because you don't want this thing falling on your...
We now return you to your regularly scheduled podcast already in progress.
Okay, so after you've given up on the pain because you found some pills in the back alley of a 7-Eleven, we're going to move on to our very last example here. The shoulder press. Just let me go grab another pill real quick. Now you actually see the bar on the ground here. You're probably wondering, why are there no safety nets for me when I do this? Because again, we're doing some ghetto lifting workouts. We don't need to worry about safety, precautions, or anything like that.
I don't like where this is going.
Just make sure you have equal amount of sand on each side, and you're going to be fine. Get right up here, just like you're gonna do a power clean. Grab the bar, pray to Lord Jesus that you don't hurt yourself now, and lift it up. Oh God. And then right here, and just like bring it up. Careful, it does shake a lot and you might hurt.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Okay. Oh, ow. Okay, actually, this is real. This is actual pain. Oh. Oh my God, ow. Ooh. Cut.
So, that's the end of the video, people. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And remember, take all injuries seriously because that can come at a very good cost. I did this for you people, so have good luck in the future. I'm going to do it now.
Are you ready, kids?
Aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, Captain!
Oh! Who lives in a big house that's not even his?
Just call me Dutch!
Cold lobster left, resting and funny is he?
Just call me Dutch!
Video battle is something you watch?
Just call me Dutch!
Then drop on the floor and laugh just like Dutch!
Just call me Dutch!
Just call me Dutch! Just call me Dutch! Just call me Dutch. Just call me.
Okay, enough of this nostalgia.
nostalgia crap. Most of the people watching this video aren't even old enough to understand when it first started. Okay? So let's forget this, because people! Why don't you check out my other videos? So like, comment, subscribe to this video, and check everything else we have posted here. Otherwise than that,
me nerd!
Yeah, that's me. I finally came back at a very long hiatus story. You probably wonder how I even got here. Let's take it back. Oh, so long ago.
What?
We need a hero. Unlike any hero. We need a hero that was once our hero. But he is gone now. And no one has seen him since. It has been so long.
Oh well, that's life. Time to actually move on now.
Now what am I gonna have for dinner tonight? You know what? Cucumber tacos. Haven't had those in ages.
Meanwhile,
the path was so long, the journey was so drenched. I traveled the world looking for the ladies, but only found the ladies wanting me for the Pika, and not the Pika wanting their Pika. I finally made it back to him, the one and true only for— Can we stop it with the music already? Thank you, one and only friend. Dutch, I am finally back from the land of MILFs, GILFs, and FILFs. How have you been, buddy? Dutch, can you please open the door for me?
Oh, yeah, no problem. I'll help you with that. There you go.
Thank you. Even though he punched me, after all I did, coming back here, it was still worth it. I'm not even worried about the pain that's gonna happen right now. Wanna why? Guess I'm so high on that rare candy right now.
Oh my god, dude! Are you okay?
I think the rare candy is making me now come down.
Oh, thank goodness. So anyways, question. How was the land of MILF, GILFs, and FILFs?
After all this time, with all the things to do with, and all the things I have seen, that is your only question!
Yeah?
It was wonderful.
Go inside. We got shit to do.
You hit me from the second floor, and now you're not coming down to get me? Oh, you son of a...
What was doing.
You didn't say you were gonna scream!
I said it three times. I have it on record. No, don't do that. No. You're going in the delete scenes now. I hear you.
Well, as you know, Mr. Just Call Me Dutch, starting tomorrow, because of the whole coronavirus and everything going on, we have finally decided to make our employees come back in tomorrow. So your boss here saying, make sure you come in tomorrow. I know this is quite understanding, so can't wait to see you tomorrow.
Wait, what?
Absolutely destroyed in that accident, Mr. Dutcher, but you still have to come to work. But you can at least now only do webcam while you're in the hospital. Welcome to Capitalist America, or you're fired.
Worth it.
Oh shit, I did this?
No, we're good.
Oh. God, fuck no. No, get off that, no! No, don't do that! Get out of here!
You got my bathroom in a video!
Okay, I'm going to be just honest here. What the hell is that on my face? What in God's name is on my goddamn face? What is that? What is it?
Hey! Besides, what the hell are you doing in the freezer anyway?
The pizza king will never do that! Ah!
That's weird. Thought something was gonna be right there. No. It can't be October already. It just can't be. Hold on. Let's check the calendar. No. Latte, the only good thing that is happening right now. And now continue.
Hell's These Nuts Donuts!
May I take your sitting?
Yes, I'd like to take an order of your finest hellnuts.
That'll be no issue. Let me see. That will be $6.66.
Oh, is there a special today?
Well, yes, there is, since it's... Would you like us to deliver?
Oh, actually, that would be very lovely.
A sense of disturbance and spookiness.
Special delivery.
What the hell is going on? I don't remember ordering anything.
What in God's name did I even order?
Hello again there, foolish one.
No way! No way I'm not doing this all over again! If you remember from last time there, broski, I am a champion!
That may be so, but I got a little present for you this time.
Okay.
That was a lot harder than expected.
No. Anything but that. No! God no! Hell no!
Oh, but it is. So you better nut up, Buttercup, because we're going for round two.
No! No!
Hey, everyone, this is Just Call Me Dutch, and this is the Halloween special. Yes, I know the spookiness is not going over the tops and the skits are a little bit different more than usual, but hey, I have to try this donut. And happy Halloween, even though it's COVID time. No one's going out! Why did they make this? Why would they ever make this? I understand everyone's doing this whole spicy thing with all the different types of foods out there, but ghost pepper donut? So yeah. Apparently, Dunkin' Donuts had released this a couple weeks ago, and I finally got my hands on it. It was not an easy venture, one can say, but it kept selling out. Who would buy this? Why would you actually technically say, we are sold out of these? These have gotten so popular, they are all over the web from different types of sources to YouTube videos. Some of my favorite people are doing it.
What?
You're mixing, okay, I gotta say maybe a little bit of kick with chocolate. I've seen like, you know, pepper chocolate, but this is a donut, people. I mean, if you're gonna do anything, put bacon on this, not a ghost pepper. My God, just why? If you're probably wondering why there's white powder on this, because my fat ass got another donut with this. And yes, I used two donuts for this because... yeah, I'm not eating soapy donuts. I may have a stomach ache from eating this, but I don't want, you know, my runs to be really running from the soap. But just why? 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 And of course you're here asking, well, are you gonna taste this or not? Well, of course I'm gonna taste it. Why wouldn't I taste such a lovely venture of pure delicious horror? This is the Halloween episode, so whatever. So when you really think about it, I think Dunkin' Donuts wanted to bring the horrors that we would have found out on the streets of wherever the hell you live during Halloween and said, hey, you know what? Let's bring the horrors to your house because that's basically looking like Satan's butthole right here. Like, look at that. Yeah, exactly what you expect to be. I'm a man of many different flavors. I'm a man who's willing to try some stuff. But this is just outright idiotic. Spice is not a problem with sweets. Very little bit, you can actually make some gourmet shit right there. But it gets to the point to where ghost pepper, what is known to be a challenge in many YouTube videos and Twitch from, you know, way back to straight eating the peppers over and over to now the one chip challenge to this. All right, I got my Rockstar energy drink right here. Not sponsored, of course. Why not, Rockstar? Why not? Screw it. Okay. It tastes like a Dunkin' Donut. That's it? This was the hype. This is nothing. Oh, I had my hopes way up. This is nothing. It just tastes like a donut. This is highly disappointing. Unlike my girlfriend's vagina.
What the hell are you doing? What in God's name is he doing? Do you want to die, good sir? Because that's how you freaking die right now. See, because, you know, there's a difference between making a joke and making a joke about your girlfriend. Do you prefer living or dead? Living, dead, living, dead, living, dead. Yeah, that's what I thought. So, rewind, people!
Except I love my girlfriend oh so, so, so much, and I would do nothing in the world to harm her.
But it doesn't really have anything else. Bacow!
What?!
Maybe I got so used to eating this kind of stuff that this is absolutely nothing to me. There's no spice. It has the heartburn, but no spice to it. 0 out of 10, 1 star, 1 out of 5, you name whatever score you want. Because this is absolutely terrible. I wanted more spookiness out of this. I wanted more horror. I wanted to be able to feel my face go numb again, but not this. Spooky, you got any ideas? Oh, that's right, my cat's cremated. Forgot about that.
Yeah, I'm gonna admit to that one. That was pretty dark. I apologize if that offended some people. Not really. I'm just saying that's a really dark joke because that happens. So, yeah. Let's get back to the video.
Leon! Oh, wow. Might as well just give me a pumpkin spice donut. That probably sounds better anyway. God damn it. Because pain could bring more into this than pleasure. This is actually tastes good. But at least pain could bring jokes. Pain could bring horror. Pain could bring a lot of different things into a video. But this is delightful. This tastes good. Dare I say, I might order it again. This, look, it's covered. It's 100% covered with these sugar crystals. And now I'm sad I threw away the other donut that's covered in salt. I'm sorry. I try to be energetic for this, but this is lame. This was lame. So, alright guys, don't worry. We got some stuff planned for the future that's going to be a little bit more energetic, lively. I'm excited as all hell because there is so much stuff out there in this world that you never know what's going to happen. So, be prepared for the next 2 weeks of videos because they are coming out. So, flex for the followers. Welcome to the channel and have a good day. Hey everyone, this is Just Call Me Dutch and today we are actually going to be doing something a little fun today. The One Chip Challenge. Doing this to myself. Not only am I recording this, I'm doing this live right now on Twitch. So not only will people see me doing this on YouTube, hopefully people on Twitch will lovely see me doing this live. But of course, this is going to be... Oh boy, I'm not excited for this. Why? And it's in a coffin, of course, because this is where exactly I'm going to end up here in the next few hours. Oh my god. Oh, it's even worse than I thought. Well, you can't smell it, so it's sealed off properly. I will give it that, as you can tell right here. Seriously, one single chip. Oh, how long can you last before throwing in the towel? Eating or drinking anything? So it goes from featherweight, 5 minutes, lightweight, middleweight, or heavyweight. The One Chip Challenge Champion. I will get this frame if I could at least make it to middleweight. Without drinking or anything. And I'm pretty good when it comes to heat. Pretty decent overall. It says, round one, a spicy punch to the tongue. Round two, a fury jab to the face. Round three, impaired vision from tears. Round four, a low blow to the gut. Then round five, K.O. Made with Carolina Reaper pepper, scorpion pepper, Szechuan peppercorn. This shirt was created for the sheer pleasure of intense heat and pain. I don't like this.
Why am I goddamn doing this, people? So I'm gonna put this right here on the plate, of course, because I'm not an idiot.
Are you sure about that?
Idea to put this on my actual table, because with my luck, a crumb's gonna be right here, and also I'm gonna wipe my eye, and I'm gonna be crying for the next 20 years. Let's give it a little smell. Oh my god! It smells. It smells like someone lit a fire in my nostrils. Jesus! Oh my goodness! Oh, of course it's not the single chip. I'm not really surprised about that much, but god, this is oil. This is oil that's stuck on here. This is not just powder. This is straight up oil. Should I give it a lick? Let's go. Let's go with the pre-warm-up. Ah! Oh my god. Yeah, there's heat. I licked that. I just licked it and I'm already dealing with this heat. I'm not ready for this. That was just the heat and it's already hitting me hard. Help! Can someone call 911 already? Because I might need it because this is going to really, really burn. Hello? Anyone? Help! Oh my god, that was a... I don't like this. Fuck! You come to watch me die? I took a crumb and it's already burning my mouth. This is fucking terrible. Oh my god. Why would anyone do this? This is happening. I gotta do this. This is seriously like if I ate Satan's butthole right now. This is what it would feel like. Second half. Alright. Second half.
Do it.
Do it!
Right here.
Do it!
Second half.
Just do it! Do it!
Oh, finish it. There you go. You got it.
Oh my god.
You got it.
Oh my god.
You got it.
No. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, it's numb. Oh. Why do people do this? Why does mankind want to do challenges like this? I am a champion. By the chip challenge. I will. This is my batter. That's upside down. This is, oh my god. Oh, I'm licking my lips. Don't do that. I'm actually shaking here. Oh my god. This is it? Yeah, that means bad. But honestly, yeah, my face is numb. I'm overall numb, but you don't need to wait an hour. I conquered this shit. I conquered this. I am the Neop Nishim
Meishin
Fine Champion. Yes, this is me. I deserve this. This belongs to me today.
make it harder for me. Is there any more in here? Oh, yep. Look at that. Try to be careful not to mess this. I'm gonna make this harder for me. I'm gonna stick my whole tongue in this hole.
Whoa, what?
Oh, come on. Look at that, see? I ain't a wimp. Look at that. Pakai ain't got nothing on me. Oh, look at that. Right here. You think it's. On. I'm trying to get my. Now I can put my finger in the hole. Okay. Okay, if you can see this. Here we go. If you can see this, right here, look at that. I'm gonna get that. Watch. Man, harder for me. Harder. My tongue is numb. Kind of like that. Technically now, I'm gonna keep it off a little longer. About 32 minutes.
Okay.
About 32 minutes. I think I held it long enough. It's not painful. It's just annoying now, people. Honestly, not hot enough. Needs to be hotter. I would do this again. Once I get monetized on YouTube. But I'll do 2 chips.
There you go.
If I got monetized on YouTube. There you go, people. The 1 chip challenge was nothing to me. I teared up, got a little numbness, but it wasn't that bad. 30 minutes, totally worth it. So like, comment, subscribe, my other crap, and have a good day.
Yeah, I'm sure you'd like that, huh?
You're on camera. You not see the record?
Oh my. Save your breath. I think if you gave childbirth.
Oh god, this is exactly.
Ew.
Okay. So here's a scene. I did not catch this. I did not mean for this to happen. It's one of those instances that it's just everything worked out perfectly. And I'm cracking up because I didn't notice this. Hold on.
Look at that. See? I ain't a wimp. Look at that. Pakai ain't got nothing on me.
I didn't notice me looking to the laptop actually goes well with the fucking vacuum. I didn't mean for that to happen. It looks like I'm staring at the vacuum. Oh, that's fucking gold. I love that. Oh.
Today?
Why no, Dutch. I have not at all.
Are you sure, man? I feel like I'm supposed to be like this chosen one that's supposed to go on this somewhat grand animated adventure.
Oh, that feeling? I mean, you know exactly what's going on now.
What's been out, Broski? What the hell's happening?
Well, my dear Dutchy friend, we're in an anime opening.
Babe!
What?
Can I go on an anime adventure that may or may not involve killing an anime god or two?
Look, I don't care what your white boy ass does with that doll.
just be back before my parents get here.
Alright, epic anime opening starts right now!
Why do you keep announcing that we're gonna go do this? Much as we'll do it seems counterintuitive!
Epic anime opening starts right now, or this guy gets punted out of the house again!
No, I don't feel like doing that again.
Welcome to the beautiful land of Buff Frost and the wonderful world of protein. I'm your host, Buff Frost. And today, I got a little something special for you all. We're going to be creating one of my favorite proteins to do. Now first, as you know, since we got to get our buffness in order over here, we got to get whole milk. As white as my nice little sculpture right here. Lovely. So head on over to your fridge, open it up, and Oh, I totally forgot. Don't mind the skulls, people. Don't worry about that. We'll come back to that later. It's because they were enemy to the protein. You don't want to be enemy to the protein, people. You don't. The next few ingredients are quite simple. We need 1 cup of milk. We need 2 scoops of proteins for my proteins. 1 tablespoon of chia seeds because the millennials eat that shit up. It's fascinating. Really is. And 1 tablespoon of creatine, because that is what muscles crave. And 1 spoonful of peanut butter, because it makes the thickness go around. And a little bit of fruit, because I love me some fruit. Like every single one of these colors.
Every time I taste the sweet bliss of the paint, brings me closer to the depths of the vegan wars again. I thought I left it all behind, but it inches closer every single day. But the paint is too good to resist. But the vegan wars, so many lost souls, losing the gains potentials. All for what? Veganism.
Oh, sorry. I'm told not to eat the lead paint. Anyways. Let's move on. And last but not least, 1 cup full of oatmeal, because thick thighs saves lives. What is he doing? What the hell is he doing? Buff Ross! Buff Ross! What? You can't think of happy little trees right now! You can see her at the club tomorrow! But thick thighs. We have a show to do!
Okay, Kevin. Buff Ross will move on. But also Buff Ross remembers those who stop his imagination from being free. And Buff Ross doesn't like that. Because Buff Ross goes out to people who messes his imagination up to the point to where he gets immoral, insane, and let's just say, adventurous thoughts one can say to be malicious. So watch your back, Kevin. Watch your back.
Is no one gonna comment on what you said to me? Because that sounded a little bit like a threat.
Anyways, let's get back to making our wonderful protein shake.
Lastly, you need it. Wait, what is he doing? Stop it! Stop it! No! Stop! You're ruining a perfection of God! The macros do not fit to this way of life! No, no, no! Not the happy little creature!
Ah! All you have a amazing happy little venture with your happy little trees in the future, ladies and gentlemen, because Bifrost is done here today. So remember, do your tries, squat with your legs, and eat your protein. So come back next week and you'll see a brand new adventure unfold in front of you called Kevin Gets What's Coming for Him. What?
In a world where only one man can do what he must to save what is left of Earth, only in extreme times calls for these extreme measures. So once again, this one man is called upon to take up the mantle he gave up long ago. You are needed again.
Like I told you, Chief, I retired that version of myself long ago.
That is besides the point. The world needs non-copyrighted green suit hero guy.
Understood.
Risking everything that was lost to him when he put the suit on the first time. Risking all his loved ones. Risking their lives to save the world. Risking his body, mind, and his life to make the world a better place.
No! Ow.
His agility, his strength, his mind will be tested like never before, to the point of pure exhaustion that he must risk. What are you doing?
Oh, this is actually how we fight people nowadays, by simply going on Twitter, looking through their post history, and trying to cancel them every single opportunity that we can get by finding the minuscule possibility that they might be racist or even finding insensitive tweets.
That doesn't seem heroic at all, but seems tedious and unfulfilling to ruin someone over what would seem okay in the past.
Oh, it's okay, it's okay. That's why you're wrong, good sir. Just keep playing the music, okay? Just follow me with what I actually are doing, okay? Okay? Just look at this, look at this. Play the music!
Oh, okay. In a world where social media warriors control the outcome of the media to bend to their whim, a single warrior, a social warrior, must search through all of Twitter to find any form on unreasonable remarks where he can shred his enemies into submission, risking all of his... No. Okay. This is just getting absolutely ridiculous. Stop the music! I am leaving! Have my check in the mail! I quit this horse shit!
Damn, man! I guess not everyone could just simply change to the new world, especially with the whole thing called technology and everything. Come on. Oh, right. Forgot to submit. And... Ha! Now the villain is screwed. Now we just sit back, relax, and let Twitter do its thing.
No! How did you find out about my secret, hero?
Oh, it was real simply, villain. After sifting through all your tweets, I, non-copyright screen suit hero guy, has found out that you hate puppies.
Wait. That's it? You don't know about my furry addiction to porn?
Now everyone on Twitter's gonna berate you all day.
Wait, what did you just say?
Nothing. Let perverts be perverts!
So I'm about to start recording over here, and there's a coyote in my recording area. I don't know what to do. I have to wait till this guy gets out of here.
I think I went a little too far for this opening. I don't think Pete is really going to be liking this one. Oh well! Hey everyone, this is Just Call Me Dutch, and today you're probably wondering what the hell's a Thanksgiving smoothie, but that is besides the point. Because we're making a Thanksgiving smoothie. So, I got inspired by this idea, before I get into the actual details of it, by this thing called Mukbang. This is another YouTuber that gets oddly popular every now and then, which I have no reason why. I watched a few of his videos, but it's just, as some Redditors might say, a little bit weird. But it's YouTube, the guy gets hundreds of thousands of views every video, so I can't really knock what's working for the guy, but still, it's always like, I'm gonna go to the nearest fast food place and buy a ton of everything on the menu, and then he eats it all or tries to. And it's a little nasty. But then he got other videos that are super sad, like breaking up with a boyfriend, going through depression, gaining 40 pounds or something like that. It's just like, no. I don't think I'm gonna do something that extreme yet. So I'm doing a little twist on that idea. And instead, we're gonna do a whole Thanksgiving meal in this blender. Lord save me now! I have every single item you can think of when it comes to Thanksgiving. I have pumpkin pie. I got stuffing right here, because I'm really gonna be stuffing this down my throat. Corn! Because everyone likes their corn! Especially if you go, you know, to the south, you got a bunch of those country boys wondering what you're gonna do with that cornbread. Always talking about corn up in Nebraska. There's nothing but corn. Seriously, there's nothing but in Nebraska besides corn, beef,
and corn.
Mac and cheese, which I don't really think that's more Thanksgiving, but we just had it at my Thanksgiving. It has bacon in it. It's actually really good, and I will die to prove that. Not really. Simple as it is, mashed taters. And this delicious, absolutely amazing turkey right over here. God, this was absolutely fan-freaking-tastic. And I can't deny it. It was just really that good. Super moist. Even the turkey breast was actually bomb as shit.
Language.
I'm excited. As you already know, this is actually quite simple. It's nothing too crazy. You just can't see me being utter idiot about this. We're gonna put all this into here, blend it, and then drink it. And we're not just gonna do a little. We're gonna actually fill this up, stuff it down my throat, and later I'm gonna have to drink some Pepto because this is gonna be absolutely disgusting to try and eat. Now, as of now, I haven't really figured out. I don't have gravy. Otherwise, I would have used the gravy as the liquid. And I can't really think of anything to use for that besides, I don't know, water. But we'll get to that when we actually start thinking about it. So we'll start off with the delicious pumpkin pie. As you can tell, it's already been eaten by my fat ass. We're gonna put a nice little heaping serving in there. The actual serving, not just a bit. Look right here, it's going right in there. Right in there. Oh no! There we go. Actually, it's good. I'm sorry. Now we got the corn here. Again, I'm not a fan of corn because of multiple different reasons. It being used as gasoline, alternative fuel, oil. So I don't really like eating corn that much. Even though I don't hate the taste of corn. It's just not one of my favorites. It's not a vegetable. Stop that. Why do people think this is a vegetable? It is not a vegetable. It is a starch. So I don't know why people think that. So we're gonna put a heaping scoop in here. Give myself a little more. Oh boy. Oh man, we're already a fifth of the way up and I'm not liking this at all. This is not good. It's like we're trying to prepare food for grandma over here. It's like, don't worry grandma, we're gonna put all your food in the blender. We're gonna stuff it right down your IV chute. A heaping scoop of the mac and cheese and bacon. Everything tastes better with bacon. It has been scientifically proven. How we made the stuffing was actually nothing too complicated. We just got a box of stuffing. But what we did is before we fed everyone, we doused it with the turkey juice. And holy crap, this thing just soaked it all up. Just soaked all the minerals and vitamins and the fat juiciness right into it. And it just made it so much better. Absolutely delicious and gorgeous. There we go. Put that in there. And I'm not too keen on these taters. Again, it's like we're feeding grandma over here with nothing but like baby mush, or we're making baby food over here. Yep, it's official. I'm gonna be a big man baby over here. Lastly, is the turkey. It really doesn't matter what piece you get. I really don't care, but I gotta make sure there's no bones in it for one. So I gotta make some, I might get something like a turkey. Oh, here we go. Here's a good piece. Ah, I think that's just straight turkey breast. I think that will work. And we're gonna stuff that right into this hole. Stuff it way up in there, Morty. Get in there. This thing already, oh my God, this thing weighs a ton. Voila. Now, I don't know what I'm gonna use for liquid, so. So after actual much consideration, I forgot two things. You gotta get the whipped cream onto your pie. Poof, I totally forgot about that. That's one of the most important things. And then, deviled eggs. Definitely something that's been very common a lot of Thanksgivings. And of course, you gotta get the Hawaiian rolls in here. How can I get it? You gotta definitely get into the smoothie a nice savory butter roll in there. Because, yeah, you know, butter is definitely gonna help this whole scenario. Fill it up with even more fine carbs. My, oh, and of course, what you're gonna do is we're gonna be a basic bitches and just use water. Because that's the least flavorful thing. Oh, Jesus. Here we go. Oh, without noticing, my actual camera just bit the shit and said, screw you, I'm not going to actually record. This is the final outcome. This delicious, blended up smoothie. I'm actually really mad right now because it didn't blend. It blended absolutely amazingly, but it didn't record. I made some hilarious jokes too. This is what happened. This is technology in the making, God damn it. The Pilgrims sailed across the ocean, dealt with horrific forms of coldness of the winters, to leave going to the prosper land, America, and to get and be crazy lunatic religious people. Seriously, that's one of the reasons why they left, because they were so religious. It wasn't religious freedom. They were so religious that they couldn't live with people who weren't as religious as them. Look into that. It's pretty gnarly. But I doubt it that in 400 years, their ancestors were going to sit down, make a video about a blended up Thanksgiving smoothie. Where were the witches about this one? Where were they? During the whole the witch trials and everything, couldn't they foreshadow something this horrific, this heinous, this complete idiocracy right here? No, because they weren't ready to deal with something so tremendously horrifying that mankind decided to create something that shouldn't be consumed by any form of human being outside being 80 years old, with no teeth, gums only, and lip smacking like a mofo who thought this would get them into a form of prosperity into the YouTube world, and thought, yes, this is my ticket into getting monetized. This is my land. This is my reward, and this is my trial to get me there. No! No one thought that, because it's not going to happen. I'm not going to get monetized just because of this one single video. It's not going to happen. Have you seen my other videos? I barely hit 10 plus views, for God's sakes. I am stalling. I'm literally praying to whatever form of God is out there. I don't even think the God of Dionysus, the God of wine and feasting and food, will look at this and call me a straight lunatic for creating an abomination that even the God of wine and feast wouldn't even touch with his pinky toe, because mankind shall not go to Olympus because of creating such horrific forms of digestible food. Can we please get a countdown?
10, 9, 8, 7. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
It tastes like stuffing! Like, really sweet stuffing! Okay. I was not expecting stuffing to be the overtaking bearer of flavorsome, but I know I ain't going to Flavortown over here anytime soon, but at least I'm not dying. I can already hear Gordon Ramsay screaming at me,
"You fucking donkey!"
saying he's seen better muck in a pig stock. But honestly, this is actually very drinkable. I was expecting a whole lot worse, like overbearing of pie and everything, but it just tastes like really sweet stuffing. I can honestly do this. Maybe Grandma has a point. But honestly, this is actually something, if you look it up, a lot of strongmen who are trying to get the calories in day would literally blend up their food into a blender just to make it easier for them to drink, eat it, because they're so sick of constantly chewing and tasting for so long that it's just easier for them to drink it. It's actually a very popular thing, and this is nothing different. But this is like something you give to Grandma. It's like, here you go, Grandma, get some gains. We want you to be able to bench 400 grandchildren or something like that. But still, it's not that bad. I've had worse. So, in order for me to fully finish this, we're just gonna show you. I'm not getting the video right now. We're gonna show you that I at least drank this. So we're gonna fast forward this portion so you can actually see me drinking this shit. Here we go. You still gotta chew it. That's the weird part. This really just smells like nothing but pumpkin spice. It feels like I walked into Starbucks, ordered the biggest pumpkin spice possible, with extra pumpkin, more pumpkin. I wanted the juices of the pumpkin. I wanted to have the sex with the pumpkin, and the pumpkin decided to put all of his sex juices into this, and this is what it smells like right now, and it's disgusting. Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting at this point. I'm getting really sick of it. I just don't even know what to do anymore. I don't know what to do with this. I don't, and I still have this much to do, and it's nauseating. Like, I want to vomit. I actually want to vomit. I don't vomit, but I want to vomit from drinking this. So yeah, it's done. I almost puked and everything. It's over, it's done with, I'm done. Hey cat, how you doing? But I gotta get going, because I'm about to flip a lid, and I'm gonna have to get a better camera for this. It's official. I can't do this anymore with this phone, because it just keeps wanting to screwing up with me. So, Flex for the followers, welcome to the channel, and have a good day. I'm gonna go puke in the trash can right now.
Got plenty of time.
Come on!
Thanks for watching the video today. As you can tell, this was just a simple strongman event. Qualified for nationals. I decided to go from here on out. Hopefully check out the other videos. Besides that, flex for the followers. Welcome to the channel and have a good day.
The new Star Wars movies suck! We wish you a merry lockdown from this horrific new year. Good buildings burning and good business bankrupt. But Republicans save the hopes now, so a happy new year. Oh, bring stimulus check now. Oh, bring normality now. Oh, bring cheaper rent now and bring it right here. Good riddance this year to you and your kin. We wish you a merry lockdown and a happy new year. They won't stop till we open. They don't understand to me now. They won't understand to reason. So bring a manager. Merry lockdown, everyone. God, this year sucked.
Hey, everyone, this is Just Call Me Dutch. And today, we're joining the hype train. Because apparently, Mr. Beast, the man with 50 million subscribers, has opened up his own, I guess I just learned this today, ghost restaurant. So you can't actually go to the restaurant and get this. You have to use Postmates or Uber Eats or any of those like available foods for driving to your home kind of things in order to get this. Now, I was a McFatty Fatty, and I got the biggest meal possible for this. This cost me $22 just to get this to my house.
Yes, you heard me exactly. $22. Why the hell was I paying for this junk?
That is not a cheap investment, especially since it's a meal for one. But I'm actually surprised he was able to do this. Mr. Beast, the man who just wants to give people money. Looking at you. Come on. You know you want to give me money, Mr. Beast. I'm reviewing your meal. And I'm going to give it the most honest review possible. Because I am not swayed over someone that just gives me a Diet Pepsi in a can. I will say this. It wasn't too expensive overall if you just ordered the regular meal. It's like $12. But me being McFatterson, I ordered the most ridiculous meal possible. It comes with a burger, fries, and a soda. And this was called Beast Style because, you know, I am a beast. I ain't the LA beast, but I can definitely say I'm somewhat of a beast. So I'm very excited to actually try this. And again, Merry Christmas to everyone, and have a horrendous year for everyone. Hopefully you're not straggling away to do anything, but we're gonna start off with, you seriously can't give me an actual soda? I guess this is because of the whole ghost restaurant thing I heard about today, that they probably don't have an actual fountain drink machine. So this is it. You only can get Pepsi, Diet Pepsi, and I think like a Dr. Pepper, and that's it. Those are your three choices, and it's only canned. I'm not really happy about that, and yes, I got the Diet Pepsi because I don't need to add more calories to what I'm about to ingest. The next thing I got is something I gotta say is actually probably going to be delicious. It's called the Beast Style. And we're gonna check it out here once I actually move the camera. Well, that's a little disappointing. I was expecting, you know, something to be covered. Paying an extra $2 for this and... Come on, man. Give me some fries or something. And cover it. Douse it. Come on. I mean, this is nothing. What is this, mayo? Wait, hold on. Is that mayo? I don't know what that is. But I was expecting to be like animal style. Something you get it up. What's it called? In-N-Out. Not this. But let's give it the actual real taste test here. Okay. Honestly, it reminds me of animal style if you go through In-N-Out. So, I'll give it a pass. Fries aren't too bad alone. Seasoned, of course, because you would be a maniac not to get this season. I mean, who wants to eat plain fries? Even though they're cold, they're not dry. I will give it that.
What is that on your lip? Lick that off your lip. You filthy animal! Sorry for the interruption, folks, but... Oh, I ain't no beast.
Have a good day.
Okay. I can get down with the spryness. Try a couple more pieces before we move on to the main event. I've always been a person who wholeheartedly believes that if you're gonna give me fries, give me fries. I know how much a potato costs, so, and it only costs you like, what, 50 cents to make this, even with the labor and everything? So come on, throw a little bit more fries in here. I mean, that's with any establishment, though. That's with any, not just Mr. Beast's burger, but that's with any establishment. God, you gotta taste that acerbate in the diet soda. And I'm going to talk. I'm supposed to be on a diet, but the second I heard this, I knew I had to make a video on it. I had to. I will give the fries a pass with everything included. So that's not too bad. But of course, you're not here. You're not here for the fries. You're not here for the Diet Pepsi. You're here for the main event, the most important part of the Mr. Beast burger meal, the Mr. Beast Beast Style Burger. I have no idea what this is gonna look like. All right. Oh, wow. Man, they really wrapped this up. Okay. This is what I'm talking about. That is a good looking burger. That is a handsome looking burger.
Like I said, I got about 4 patties here. Doesn't look too bad, comes with a little bit of bacon. The bacon's a little bit, that's some really thin bacon right there, come on. The patty doesn't look that bad. Let's flip it under. It doesn't help that this has been, you know, waiting for me. Okay, it's a little bit wet, but again, it takes some time. Got some sauce in here. Okay, you know what? You know what? This doesn't look too bad. Even the burger doesn't look too bad. I can tell you this much is better than, you know, looking at McDonald's, but it does have some similarities to some other proprietors of the burger.
Mouth-watering taste. I've been waiting. I haven't eaten all day because I saved all my calories for this burger. Uh-oh. Wait, how many patties did you give me? This is not what I ordered. I wanted 4 patties. I am sad and disappointed. What the hell? I ordered a triple patty with an extra patty, extra cheese, lettuce, onions, everything. I added everything on here and I'm going through checking, but not the quadruple patty. I ordered an extra patty for this. So, Mr. Beast, I'm sorry, man. I know this is your business and this is just a small proprietor or little franchise in your name. I'm a little disappointed in that. That for the first time, this is your first week opening this line, and I didn't get, to be fair, exactly what I ordered. I paid for it. You got the fries right. I'll give you that. But the patty, the burger is different. Then it's not like an In-N-Out. Different than McDonald's. Okay, better than McDonald's. Better than Burger King. Let me see. You know what? I would say this. Better than any commercial fast food. I will say that. I would give it to like on par to quality. To In-N-Out, Five Guys, Shaken Burger, Shaken Bug, whatever you want to call that. An equivalence of quality. So, though the order is wrong, the quality is there, Mr. Beast, and I am satisfied at the very least of that. The man is so well known for giving people so many things, from money, cars, to now he just passed a massive charity that's feeding or helping hundreds of people, thousands of people. He does more than, quite frankly, than probably some millionaires actually do. The man puts his money where his mouth is. And for something like this to be as successful as it is, bravo, good sir. Bravo. Now in the future, I want to be able to actually go to this place and just pick it up. You don't have to drive it. I don't have to go inside. You can bring it down just so I can save a couple bucks. Because I want to eat more of this, but if you're going to cost me like $4 to $5 just for it to come to me. I don't know, man. But that's just me. So if I was you, I'd give it a shot, everyone. Be prepared to pay a little bit of a price because of Postmates or Grubhub or wherever those apps allow you to purchase this. Be prepared to pay a whopping easy $15 to $20 for this. I'll be overall satisfied at the very least. You're not paying for junk here. You're not paying for low quality, low tier. You're paying for something that I can say is an equivalent to In-N-Out, Five Guys, or Burger Shack. That's the one I was thinking of, was Burger Shack. So, give it a shot, everyone. I'm going to finish this burger by myself because I want to eat alone. And lastly, Merry Christmas, everyone. Have a Happy New Year. Hopefully everyone gets their stimulus checks. Oh, excuse me. Soon enough, because I need that money. I really do. Besides that, flex for the ballers. Eat Mr. Beast Burger and have a soda with it. That's it.
Hey everyone, thank you all for watching this insanely long video. Well, that was it, 2020. So let's move on to 2021. Hopefully everyone stays until then. And flex for the followers. Check out my other videos that come in the future. And have a good day.